These are the four integrals. Their method of integration is as follows. Let us consider the first one. And if you know the integration of this first one, then you will be able to integrate all these integrals, all the rest integrals. 1 upon 1 plus 10x. This we can write as 1 upon 1 plus sin x upon cos x dx is equal to 1 upon 1 plus one plus sin x upon cos x, we can write as cos x plus sin x upon sin x if we take LCM. Upon cos x is equal to, we can write this as cos x upon sin x plus cos x. Now the integral I can be written as 1 upon 2 cos x upon sin x plus cos x on multiplying and dividing by 2. So it's an important step of this integral, a key step to integrate this integral. Multiplying and dividing by 2 now, and this 2 cos x should be written like this: sin x plus cos x minus sin x minus cos x. You can see what we did: added sin x and subtracted sin x. This minus and this minus will cancel each other, so it becomes again cos x. So cos x plus cos x remain 2 cos x. So the additional thing what we did is added and subtracted sin x. In denominator, it is sin x plus cos x. Dx is there. 1 by 2. Now we can separate the integral in two parts. First part is sin x plus cos x upon sin x plus cos x minus sin x minus cos x upon sin x plus cos x dx. Sin x plus cos x, sin x plus cos x can be cancelled. So it will be 1. So the integral will be like this: 1 by 2 bracket integral of 1. Of course, dx is there, minus. And if we introduce this minus inside the integral, it can be written like this: cos x minus sin x. If we insert this minus inside this bracket, it will become cos x minus sin x upon sin x plus cos x dx. So now it is visible to you that numerator has become derivative of denominator. So the first part of integral should be integrated as usual. Integral of 1 is x. Now to integrate this cos x minus sin x upon sin x plus cos x we shall substitute denominator as t. So on substituting, t is equal to sine x plus cos x. dt by dx will be cos x minus sin x, which implies dt is equal to cos x minus sin x dx. Therefore, the integral I will be 1 upon 2 bracket x plus cos x minus sin x dx, cos x minus sin x dx of integral can be replaced by dt, and denominator we have substituted as t, so it is t. Now its integral will be 1 by 2 bracket x plus integral 1 of 1 by t is log of t base e plus an integral constant c. And at the last, we will have to substitute value of t, x plus log of value of t, which is sine x plus cos x base e plus an integral constant c. So in this way, I expect you to integrate all these two integrals, this integral and this integral. So all these integrals can be integrated using the same technique, multiplying and dividing by two and adding and subtracting something which is needed, and then substitute denominator as t of the second integral. So hope you could have understood this.